Hey guys, what is up? Welcome back. For today's video, I wanted to share with you guys an eyeshadow palette declutter video. Now, this is not going to be my like full in-depth palette declutter video. I'm going to have that up hopefully in the next little bit. But I've been just looking at my drawers and I was thinking to myself that I want to get rid of 10 palettes just to kind of get the ball rolling to see what the vibe is like. You know, kind of get rid of items that I haven't really been using. To kind of just give them a new home and also to make a bit more space in my drawer. So I have this drawer right over here with a bunch of palettes, and I feel like it constantly gets messy because I just have to always like reorganize, which is cool. We have that. We also have this drawer, and then hopping over to this side, we also have this drawer as well. So we're gonna start with this one right over here, and I will be posting these palettes on Poshmark. If I did purchase them myself and it fits still in good conditions, I'll have my Poshmark linked down below. But yeah, let's get started with this one. Let's see here. What do I wanna get rid of? Yeah, I think I know. The first palette I think I'm gonna get rid of is this one right here by Juvia's Place. It's the Saharian palette by Juvia's Place. Here is what the palette looks like. I feel like I've given this palette so many different chances, so many different tries to see if it would work out for me. I'm just not a massive fan, but I hear such amazing things about Juvia's Place palettes and shadows in general, so I was like, you know, like, why isn't it working for me, you know? Anyways, the metallics I feel like are very thick. They apply somewhat nicely on the lids, but it takes a little bit to get there, and also they just feel like thick. I'm not really feeling that. And the mattes were decent, a little bit more on the drier side. I probably like the mattes more than the metallics, but this just simply didn't work out for me. I want to see what their other palettes have to offer, though. But I'm going to get rid of this one. As for what's next, so there are still some palettes here that I would still love to give a try. But let's see. Okay, I think I'm going to get rid of this. So this palette right here, let's zoom you out a little. So this palette right here is the BH Cosmetics Zodiac's Love Signs palette. I was so excited about this one because I do really enjoy the original one a lot. So I wanted to give this one a go. Also, I am into horoscopes to an extent. I am right over here, Scorpio. So, you know, there definitely is a vibe with this one. However, I just felt like the quality just wasn't there. I like the original one more in regards to quality, but I think I like this color story more than the original one. But this just doesn't perform as nicely as I would like. The mattes were good, but the metallics, the big shades, I feel like were very thin and they looked very like messy on the eye, like very like flaky, very like almost cheap. I guess if I would have used it with water or Fix Plus or something, I probably could have made it work. But I mean, I just feel like there are other palettes in my collection that I prefer to use over this one, so I think I'm gonna declutter this palette. Okay, let's see. So the original one, for now, I'm still gonna keep. I do really like that. Okay, maybe one of these. No, I think I'm gonna get them. There are certain palettes that I would love to get rid of, like this one, for example, but I still wanna do a disappointing makeup products video of 2021, and this is definitely gonna be there. I just was not feeling it, and I felt like the quality was just not there. But I wanna keep it for that video, so we'll keep that. Let's see. Let's go into this drawer right over here. Okay, sorry, my sneakers are just... Okay, so for this drawer, I think I'm gonna go ahead and declutter this right here by Huda Beauty. This is the Ruby Obsessions palette. So I do speak about these palettes by Huda Beauty quite frequently on my channel. The color story ones are very hit or miss. My least favorite one is the green one. And then I would say this one is, I don't know if it's a close second, but it's not my ultimate favorite. The purple one, the amethyst one, is pretty good. It was in my top 10 favorite eyeshadow palettes that I recently filmed. But I just find that I really don't use this as much. I don't really gravitate towards these colors per se. And I think I do actually have other palettes that have like a similar color story to this one. If I had to choose this one or the purple, I prefer the purple tones more on me. So I think I'm going to say goodbye to this. I'm going to declutter. Okay, I'm just thinking, what else? All right, let's see what else we got here. I think I'm going to declutter this one right here by Lorac. This was their Mega 3 palette. So I actually did get a decent amount of usage out of this one. You guys can see here. And I think that the color story is really nice. You get tons of neutrals on this side and then some deeper shades here. You can kind of use this for a more natural day-to-day look, but spice things up as well. The formula is very nice, very smooth, very buildable, easy to work with. A little bit of fallout, but it's such an amazing formula. these days, I feel like I don't necessarily use huge jungle palettes as much. I did recently purchase one or two bigger ones, but that's because I'm just obsessed with the color story at the moment. But for this one, I feel like it did have its time, and I just feel like I'm ready to part ways with it. Also, a lot of these tones do end up looking somewhat pretty similar, and there are other like day-to-day palettes that I prefer to use over this one, like Natasha Denona palettes, because you know I'm obsessed. So yeah, I think I'm gonna go ahead and say goodbye. The next palette that I definitely know I'm gonna get rid of is this one right over here from Lime Crime. So I love the Venus 3. This is how I do my threes. That's like the purpley tone palette. Here, I'll show you. This is one of my favorite palettes ever. I included it in my top 10 favorite palettes of all time. This is like my babe. So totally keeping that. But this one right here was one that I thought I was gonna love, but I don't really love it as much. I mean, it's not necessarily a newer palette per se, but it is somewhat pretty new to me. I think I maybe only use it maybe 2 or 3 times. I think that the black in here is a little bit hard to work with, and then these deeper tones, just a little bit hard for me to blend. I know that Natasha Denona is coming out with a similar palette to this one for holiday. I've seen like sneak peeks of that palette on Instagram. I legit cannot wait. Like, my heart's skipping beats because I'm so excited. That's just gonna be my jam of life, because I do like the color story of this one and I would love for this to work out, but for some reason it's a little bit of a challenging palette to work with, especially since it's deeper tones. I mean, Lime Crime's formula in general is not my ultimate favorite, but like, for these tones and their formula, it works out well. But for this one, it's a little bit of a challenge for me. So I hope to pick up that Natasha Denona palette. I'll throw up a pic here of what that looks like. And I know that's going to be my babe. So to make room for that one, I'm going to go ahead and say goodbye to this. 2, 3, 4, 5. So I decluttered 5 so far. We have 5 more to go. Okay, I think it's time to say goodbye to this palette right over here. This is the Soft Glam Eyeshadow Palette by ABH. So I spoke about this in one of my recent videos where I talked about just makeup I just didn't necessarily like feel inspired by or didn't really care about as much. I like the color story of this. I think it's really pretty, very nice, very neutral, and you can do a lot, but I haven't used it in a bit. And also, I just feel like there are other formulas that I prefer more than this one, aka Natasha Denona. You would think I'd be getting paid for this, but I'm totally not. I'm just obsessed with her formula. But not only that, it's also like, I just feel like I'm kind of over this vibe. If I had to choose one of the ABH palettes, I can't find the palette now, but it's the Norvina eyeshadow palette that comes just like this. So I was contemplating on keeping this for a bit, but then I'm thinking like, I just don't see myself really reaching for this. Okay, let's see here. These I think I'm gonna keep. You know what I'm gonna get rid of? I think it's in here. Yeah, okay, let me show you guys. So I think I'm gonna say goodbye to this palette right here. It's actually one of the newer Too Faced palettes. It's called the Light My Fire palette. And I mean, I'm obsessed with these little ones from them because I think they're just so cute, perfect to travel with. Packaging is always 10 out of 10. But in a way, I feel like they kind of overdid it. So in a way, I personally feel like it lost its touch. Also, so I have a lot of these little ones in my collection, but this one right here is probably my least favorite. I used to be really, really into these kind of colors, not so much now. And also, it's such a basic palette for me where I feel like I have these shades probably a few times over in other palettes. The formula of this one also is not like the ultimate best. So that's also why I just don't mind not having it in my collection. So I'm gonna declutter that one. But I'm still gonna keep these little guys because this is like one of my favorites ever. Even though it was limited edition, that was like one of the best ones. This is not bad, not my favorite. This also so good. So good. It came out a few years ago. And this one also just came out a few years ago, but it's also, I used to wear this daily. But yeah, I'm gonna keep those. And this one is nice as well, so I'm gonna keep this too. Oh, we also got this one. This is also a good one. This shade right here broke a little, but also one of the better ones out there. Okay, I think that's pretty much it for this drawer. Let's hop into the other one. And the other one is right over here. Let's see if we can do this. Okay, fine. So in this drawer here, I'm gonna go ahead and declutter the Smoke Show palette. I did not like the quality of this one. I feel like with ColourPop, it could be hit or miss. So one second here. So I'm gonna say goodbye. I didn't even use this way too many times, but like the 1 or 2 times I used it, I was like, eh, you know. Also, since it does have a very similar color story to that Lime Crime palette I just decluttered, like I said, the Natasha Denona one is gonna come out. So I feel like I'm gonna get my my wants with Natasha's palettes, I don't necessarily feel like I need to use this and make this work if I'm not obsessed with the actual formula of this one. Love the color story, but hopefully Natasha's will not disappoint. So I'm going to declutter the Smoke Show palette by ColourPop. Okay, we have two more palettes to go. I think I'm going to get rid of this palette right here by Marc Jacobs. No, I don't want to get rid of that. Wait. Not yet. Let's see here. I think I'm going to get rid of this one. This is the Burn Book by Storybook Cosmetics. I don't even know if I've used this even once. I pretty much just purchased it for display purposes, really. So I used to display this, and then once I kind of organized my shelves, I just, you know, exchanged it with like other goods. Also, because since I'm not really using it and I mainly purchased it for display purposes, like I said 16 times, I feel like it is taking up a lot of space in the drawer. So I'm gonna declutter that. That is gonna be the 9th palette in total, I think. I'm just looking at these two palettes here from ColourPop. So we have the Main Squeeze, which is the redder palette, and then Strawberry Shortcake, which I would say is more pinky red. I think I'm going to get rid of Main Squeeze. I actually have one of the BH palettes in the other drawer that has like the red theme going. So I don't really wear like red shadows too often to feel the need to keep this. So I'm going to declutter this one, and I am going to keep the BH one that I have in the other drawer. So declutter that. Okay, don't mind the dirty laundry. Okay, so here are the palettes that I'm decluttering, and I'm pretty happy with my decision. So now that I have a little bit more space, I'm going to try to organize these palettes in a way where they're easily accessible. So we have, again, that drawer, this drawer right over here, and then this one. Maybe I could even try to see if it all fits in two drawers without being too squishy. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I also wanted to show you guys the candle I'm burning. So we have the Bath & Body Works Fresh Spring Morning Candle. So good. All right, so that's pretty much it. Let me know what you guys thought of this video. Keep me posted. Looking forward to reading your comments, and I'll see you guys in my next one.